All right, I got a somewhat short one for you. It's a review, not on the game itself, but a controller. I've been using it for a good long while, so talk about this. I'm going to use the system a little bit more before I say, what I think about it overall, but that's a little bit different than just using a controller, you know what I mean? So it's the PC Engine controller, and this is the standard default one, although there was one that came out slightly before this, I think, or maybe it was at the same time or a little bit after, I can't remember, that had built-in turbo. So that's the next one that's compared to this. But this is the standard default one that you get with the Japanese small white one PC Engine, TurboGrafx-16 in Japan. So there's not much to say about this, so let's just go over it, and then I'll tell you what I think about it, having used it for quite a lot. I play the PC Engine a lot since I've gotten it. Anyway, trying to get the wire around here. Anyway, so let's go over this real quick, what it's got on it, which is not much, as I mentioned. It's a lot like an NES controller in a way, but it's slightly more rounded, as you can see on the sides there. And just like the NES, it only has two, as I call them, action buttons or face buttons. Select and start, or in this case it's called run. Same exact button, does the same exact thing, it's just called a different name. And the D-pad. Now the D-pad is pretty stiff. It's not as loose as like a Genesis Mega Drive controller, but that's fine. I don't mind it. But after using it for a while, or maybe it's just the position you hold the controller in, like this part of your hand right here, where there's a muscle in there called the saddle joint, whatever. Not really necessary, but I said it anyway. It, to me at least, it feels like it starts getting like it starts hurting after a while if you've been playing for a while. Now, the reason I'm bringing it up is I think maybe it's because the D-pad is stiff. I'm not sure. But there's nothing wrong with a stiff D-pad. It feels fine, as long as it's not really mushy and it's, accurate and responds well, which it does. The controller itself is pretty light. There's not much to it. The cord for it, while I wouldn't call it exactly long, I wouldn't call it short either. It's kind of like right at the cutoff of what you would consider to be either. So it's decently long. The plug on here is a very big one. It's got almost like a serial port, like on a computer would have, older computers anyway. I didn't know this at first, but I asked around, and I've been told this, like if you were to use this controller in a TurboGrafx-16, this plug, even though it's similar in what it looks like, it's actually a different size. I'm bringing it up just in case you didn't know, whoever's listening to this, because I didn't know it originally. So if you wanted to use, say, this controller on a TurboGrafx-16, while the plug might look similar, it's not going to fit and it won't work. Oh well. So there's that. Now with all the overview of the controller itself out of the way, now I'm just going to tell you what I think about it. Just like the NES controller, which and the Master System controller, which is a lot like this one, other than some obvious differences, just called 1 and 2 instead of A and B, or button 1 and 2, like on the Master System. I like it a lot. It's nice and it's a perfect size, I think. It's not too small, it's not too big. It feels good. The curved part is nice. It's not as sharp as like the NES or the Master System controller, which is nice. Buttons are nice and responsive. They're not too loud. Select and start work perfectly fine. Those are rubberized. And as I already mentioned, the D-pad, pretty stiff, but it's very responsive, Whether you're playing something like a space shooter or shmup or whatever else, or a side-scrolling platformer or a beat-em-up brawler or racing game, it works perfectly fine. About the only thing that this controller isn't good for is the fighting games, which there isn't that many on there that can use the six-button controller, but it's definitely better to have one of those. You can play those with this controller, I might as well mention. You just, I can't remember if it's select or run. It's select. You hit that to select between kicks and punches, much like you would do on a Genesis Mega Drive if you only had a three-button controller and you're playing Mortal Kombat, for example. You'd hit start to switch between kicks and punches. Yes, it is very awkward and not really the best way to play it, and you'll play more effectively with a six-button controller, but if all you have is this, it is possible. I was messing around with that quite a bit, and you can, if you get used to it, you can pull off things halfway decently. Just make sure you back off when you decide to hit the button and change between kicks and punches. Other than that, it's not that much of a big deal. So there isn't that many fighting games on it that you'd need that kind of thing. So overall though, this is a very good controller, even though it's very basic and standard for the PC Engine. As I said, there is a version of this that looks pretty much exactly the same, but it has turbo built in for these two buttons. I'd say if you're looking for a controller replacement, probably go with that one just so you have turbo, because it'll be less frustrating than mashing the button all the time in those certain games. So that's my recommendation in that case. But other than that, this is a perfectly fine controller. Nothing much wrong with it. It's very simple and basic. Not much else to say about it, really. I do like the color combo. I want to say that. The black and or gray, I guess, and red looks nice. I don't know. It's a good controller for it. So, went a little longer than I probably should have, but oh well. So that's it. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.